So here we go. Let's begin here with pick number one. And we go to Pau Gasol. Pau, I mean, how much thought have you put into this one here?
I put quite a bit of thought into this one, you know, because my decision is I'm a little torn about this one. You know, from one end, I had such a great experience, and I want to kind of run it back with some of the guys that I had last year, and I'm going to try to do that. But obviously, it's not going to be completely up to me. But I think at the same time, I want to get to know and hang out with some different guys, some different young stars. So with my first pick, I'm going to go with Victor Wembanyama from the San Antonio Spurs.
It took all that to say that. I mean, come on. I think everybody in the room knew where you were going with that number one pick, pal.
Hey. No. It was...
All right. Victor Wembanyama, one of the front runners for Rookie of the Year, if not the front runner right now. He's had an unbelievable first campaign in the NBA for the Spurs, although I'm not so sure how Laker Nation feels about you making that pick with picking a Spur number one. All right, so Pau's got the first of seven slots filled on his team. Let's go to Tamika Catchings with one name off the board and several others to pick from. This is where I think the draft is going to start to get real interesting here.
Well, with my first pick, I am going to go with Paolo Banchero.
All right, from the Orlando Magic, Paolo is a sophomore. He has had a great sophomore campaign, so much so that he will be playing Friday and on Sunday as a member of the Eastern Conference Reserves. He is the reigning Rookie of the Year for the seventh-seeded Magic this year. So he has had a sensational year. And I tell you what, Jalen seems to be smiling here. I think he did not expect you to take Paolo with the number two pick in the draft. Jalen, what do you got up your sleeves for pick number three, the final pick of round number one?
I'm so excited, and I just can't hide it. So I'm going to reward winning, first and foremost. And there's a team in Oklahoma City that has the number one seed in the West, and they have the guy that might actually win Rookie of the Year this season. I'm going Chet Holmgren with my first pick.
The number two pick of the 2022 NBA Draft. No question, as Jalen mentioned, he's right up there with Victor Wembanyama for Rookie of the Year honors. He has helped this Oklahoma City team be one of the biggest surprises in all of the NBA this year. And think about him, averaging nearly 17 points, 7.5 rebounds, and more than 2.5 blocks per game. He has been a menace protecting the rim. Cannot wait for that Victor versus Chet matchup here on Friday night of All-Star Weekend. So, Jalen, you got the last pick of the first round, and now in our snake draft format, you get the first pick of the second round.
Hall of Famers like Powell and Tamika know about camaraderie and teamwork and how much it matters so very much to winning. So it's only right that not only do I take a Jalen Williams, but he's only shooting 45% from three and averaging 19 points per game.
Jalen Williams, the first pick of the second round, fourth overall, the 12th pick back in the 2022 NBA draft. One of two Jalen Williams on the Thunder, but the only one playing in this game. How about his year? More than 18.5 points per game and has been tremendous on the defensive end with more than a steal per outing. So a great two-way threat there from both of Jalen's top two picks. We go back to Tamika for the second pick of round two.
Well, so the young man I'm going to pick, I have some strong ties with, and I'm a huge fan of his mom, who also was my teammate, Neil Ivey. I'm going with Jaden Ivey for my number two from Detroit. Love his game, love him as a person, as a player, and I remember carrying him around as a baby. So now to be on this side and watch him, I can't go wrong with Jaden Ivey.
And you're picking him at the right time as well. Over his last 10 games, Ivy has really erupted, averaging nearly 19 points, shooting nearly 50% from the field over the last 10. So Jaden Ivey, I think is a disappointment to Jalen Rose. I think he was trying to scoop up anyone named Jalen and anyone playing in the city of Detroit.
Facts. Great pick, Tamika. And rightfully so, that's a terrific story. He's a great young man from a great family. He's going to be a terrific player for a long time.
Yes, he
Let's go back to Powell for the final pick of round two.
Yeah, great picks, guys. You know, those guys were high up in my list as well. And love Jalen Ivy as well. I had him last year, and he did an amazing job. I loved him as a kid as well. All right, so the last pick of the second round, I'm going to go with a kid that you know, has been really impressing me a lot the last games, showing a lot of character. Another great rookie, Brandon Miller of the Charlotte Hornets. He's shooting the ball extremely well, really fearless. I love how fearless this kid is, showing a lot of range. You know, I think it's going to come in really handy in my matches coming up in this Rising Stars contest.
No question, a two-way guy, another guy that's thrown his name into the mix as one of the top five rookies in the NBA this season. And as Powell mentioned, over his last couple of weeks, he has really started to come along as he has really been able to score the ball at a high clip. So Brandon Miller and Victor Wembanyama, the first two picks for Powell. Powell, we got a very, very interesting team. I mean, it looks like you're building old school inside out here with a 5 and then a 3-4 in Miller. And you're going to start the third round for us here, Powell.
Yeah, which it takes me to my next pick. You know, I think I need to secure a guard here for my next pick. And I'm between two great guards, but I think I'm going to go with a guy that I've been watching quite a bit here, being settled in the Bay Area that we live in. Brandon Podziemski is a guy that is just such a competitive player, does a little bit of everything, rebounds the ball, makes a lot of winning plays, assists, great shooter from the outside, just a scrappy player. So I think it's going to be a great compliment for Brandon and Victor.
Many consider him the steal of the 2023 NBA draft. The Warriors got him with the 19th pick. And he's been averaging 9.5 points, 5.5 rebounds, and more than 3.5 assists per game. A guy that has earned his way into the starting lineup at times this season for Steve Kerr. So Brandon Podziemski, the third pick for Pau Gasol as we begin round number three. All right. Let's see, Tamika, you've gone here with a guy you know really well in Jaden Ivey. You went with Paolo Banchero, who is one of the top players, one of the best athletes on this board. You got a lot of decisions to make here.
I do, and I need to get a big guy, big man. So I am going to go. I think I'm going to go with somebody that Jaden's used to playing with so that we can go ahead and round up our post game, get a little action down low. So let's go with Jalen Duran.
Wow, Jalen Duran from the Detroit Pistons. I think she's making these picks just to annoy Jalen Rose because his goal was to get every Jalen.
Oh, I'm sorry, Jalen.
Jalen Duran in his second. He was the 13th pick back in 2022 in 34 games this season, averaging 14 points a night and more than 11.5 rebounds. Man, so you can't get everybody from Detroit. You can't get everybody named Jalen. Does this totally blow up your draft board?
It does blow up my draft board, absolutely. And the thing is, Powell and Tamika, I wanted to show you guys because I bought props. Fans get rings too. And even though I didn't win one playing, we got three as a franchise in Detroit. Please believe that. Bad boys. That being said, my next pick, wow, I want to go Benedict Mathurin because he's a guy that can get his own shot off the dribble. He can play in the starting lineup. He can come off the bench. Indiana's one of the best teams in the Eastern Conference. And what they built with that backcourt over there with he and Halliburton, the sky's the limit for them. And he's going to be playing in front of his hometown fans. And Tamika knows in 49 states is basketball, but that's Indiana. And he going to show up ready to do work.
Well, Ben Matherin, one of the well, you can't have him. I mean, maybe we can convince people to make some trades here, but we can't do that either. Ben Matherin, one of the top scorers in this pool of draft guys that are eligible to be drafted, averaging more than 14.5 points per game on the highest scoring team in the NBA, the Indiana Pacers. And I'm sure Jalen will have those engines revved up to run the pace. I mean, Jalen, is that going to be your strategy here to run as much as possible with your team?
Absolutely. In body position, this basketball, Chet might be bringing it up, initiating the offense. Got defenders as well and toughness, guys that's going to finish at the bucket. I'm excited about my team so far.
All right. Well, you get to start us off here in round number 4, Jalen. There are no more Jalens, and I don't see anybody else from the Pistons. So where are you going?
I agree. So this next pick, you know, one of my former Detroit Pistons guys that I love to watch perform is Chauncey Billups. And he talks glowing about Shaedon Sharpe and his work ethic, his discipline, and his ability to get his own shot. And how he's a heat check guy that once he gets going, he's very hard to stop. That is my next pick, the Portland guard.
The 7th pick of the 2023 NBA draft. He has been a highlight reel for the Portland Trailblazers. You see him there with the defensive effort. Man, oh man. See, I wasn't sure where you were going. There were two different guys you could have gone there, Jalen. Were you torn with that pick?
I was definitely torn. That's why I had to acknowledge Mr. Big Shot. And I think that was the...
Because he's got a couple guys here.
Yeah. My pick.
All right, Tamika, you're up next here. 2nd pick, round number 4.
Ooh, I am going to go with... I'm Sacramento, I'm going with Keegan Murray.
One of the top 3-pointer shooters in the NBA this year. He is the 4th pick of the 2022 NBA draft. He had a career high not too long ago of 47 points. This guy, Tamika, is a bucket.
Yes. All day, every day.
Can't wait to see what he's done. In that 47-point game, he hit 11 threes. In fact, he hit 11 straight without missing. So you got the 3-point shooting there from Tamika, and we round out round number 4 with Team Powell.
All right. Well, guys, you guys continue to make great picks. But, you know, obviously a lot of talented kids here. So I'm just going to continue to build strength in my roster. And I'm going to go with Jaques Jr. from the Miami Heat. He's playing extremely well. Another great pick. By Miami, and just really like his game, overall game, his competitiveness, his poise. He competes, and he's just got a great all-around game, good size. So, I think it's a great addition to our roster, for sure.
Miami Jaques, 4th among rookies this year in the NBA in scoring at more than 13 a night. And there was a period when you looked at the NBA rookie ladder on NBA.com where Jaques was truly challenging the likes of Chet and Wemby with his play. With all that adversity and injuries in Miami, Jaques has stepped right in as a prototypical Miami Heat type of player, and he has excelled for Eric Spoelstra. He'll look real good playing for Team Powell. All right, Powell. So you go with Jaques. Right. You've got two guys that are in the running for Rookie of the Year on your team already, and now you begin round number 5.
All right. And I feel like pretty much my teams are all rookies at this point, so I have to add a little experience to my roster. So I'm going to go with Jabari Smith Jr. From the Houston Rockets. I think he's definitely stepped up his game this season from last season. producing a lot and well, playing really well for Houston and Ime. So I'm really excited to be able to pick him and have him on my roster.
To call him a 3-and-D player would truly minimize what he does on the court each and every night, but he is lethal from distance and he does defend at a very, very high rate. I think Powell will truly enjoy having Jabari Smith Jr. on his team. Remember when he got in LeBron James' ear and says, "My dad was on the Sacramento Kings when you made your NBA debut." That's how he gets underneath guys' skin too. It's real fun. All right, Tamika, here we go. Round five.
Well, one great thing is I have a team full of some amazing players, amazing athletes. Jaden can play my one or my two, but I think I need somebody that can also dish the ball to him and the other players as well. So averaging 4.6 assists per game, I'm going with Scoot Henderson from Portland.
And not only is he a great player, but Tamika, he has got some experience in this format. This will be the third different time that Scoot Henderson has participated in the Rising Stars game, because remember, he was part of a G League team for 2 years playing for G League Ignite. So he knows what it takes to have to win multiple games to bring Tamika a championship. So Scoot Henderson of the Portland Trailblazers, that's the guy that I thought that Jalen was going with his last pick. But now he's got his guards. Let's see if you're going big or you're going small here, Jalen.
So I'm going oohs and ahs. And he plays in New Orleans. No, I'm sorry. I'm going to switch that up. Ooh. I'm still going.
The card had not been handed in yet.
And he's been balling lately with Luka. Derek Lively. And that's how he plays around the rim.
Jalen, you got another dude who can jump out of the rim and another rim protector. I mean, are you going to go double big and put Lively next to Chet Holmgren? How's anybody going to score?
Absolutely. That's the goal, Jarrett. The hoop is always 10 feet tall. It's a tall man's game. Powell knows this. That's why anytime there's a 6'10 guy that can do what a 6'1 guy can do, you're going to take the 6'10 guy. There you
go. When you're talking about defense, Wembanyama leads rookies in blocks per game. Chet is second. Derek Lively is third. That's a monster defense there for Jalen coming up on his team. All right, Jalen, you get to start us off again.
New Orleans, guard, bucket getter, Jordan Hawkins. Willie Green just raves about what he brings to the locker room and what he brings to the floor. And I'm expecting that exact same productivity during this Rising Stars game. I'm excited about our roster and excited to have him on our squad.
Jalen, I'll tell you what, if Jordan Hawkins wasn't on arguably the deepest team in the NBA, this dude might be getting a lot more love from around the country with the way he could shoot the ball. Remember, winning a national championship last year with UConn, comes into the NBA, is shooting 38% from three-point territory this season. And really, it's a struggle to get on the court because of how much talent is in front of him. So, Jalen, nice job with that pick. Let's go to Tamika.
Ooh, all right. So with my next pick, I'm actually going to go going with another guard from Utah Jazz. I'm going to go with Keontae George.
Keontae was the 16th pick of the 2023 NBA draft, 7th among rookies in scoring this year. A combo guy that gives a lot of versatility to Tamika's backcourt, and we see what type of roster she is building with that. Love this pick. This is a Utah team that's fun, exciting, and you're getting a real competitor in Keontae George, who, again, is averaging just over 10 points a game in his rookie season. Pardon me, over 11 points a game in his rookie season for the Utah Jazz. We'll get back to Tamika for her final pick in just a moment. Now we go to Pau Gasol for the 6th and 7th pick.
Again, great picks, guys. But there's still a lot of good talent here left. And I'm going to go to my final two picks. I'm going to go with a guy that has also been playing really well and helping the OKC Thunder get to the where they are, which is Cason Wallace. You know, it's really hard to get in that rotation in this young Thunder team, and this guy has been playing well. So, you know, it's a great addition to already our extremely talented roster. So I'm excited to have him on board.
Another guy that's behind a lot of talented guys in front of him in Oklahoma City, but when he's been on the court for Mark Daigneault, he has impressed. He was the 10th pick back in 2023 and has shown incredible versatility. He's shooting 51% from the floor, which is incredible for a guard, and 41% from three. And what he brings defensively is quite impressive as well. So that is your 6th pick. You have one more spot, pal. Let's just look at your roster. What do you think you need here before we get to the name? Like, what are your needs that you need to shore up this squad?
I mean, I got size, right? On with Victor, with Jabari, on that they can play the four and the five position. You know, I got shooting, Brandon Millage, also Jaime with all around game. Brennan and Cason are going to bring me the point guard. So I can really go either way. I can get a little bigger, or I can get a little faster and a little smaller. You know, the reality of these games is they're high-paced games. They're up and down games. There are a lot of outside shooting games. So I'm going to go and add some a little more European flavor to my team, and a good compliment and friend to Victor. So Bilal, it's going to be Koulibaly is going to be my pick, my final pick.
Man, oh man, you are not only building a strong roster, but the top end of your roster really likes what you're doing. Victor Wembanyama's got to be going nuts right now. He gets to play with the guy that he was teammates with last year on the Met 92 team in France. Koulibaly is a 6'8 guard who really has gotten increased playing time over the last couple of weeks, and he has been explosive for the Washington Wizards. So that is, man, I tell you what, Tamika, the way Powell framed that is, I could really go either way. You know, my roster is so good. I could take a big, I could take a small, it doesn't matter. I mean, he was just like, man, what do you have to say?
He did. He played her, right? But there's two more great players that are out there. And I think the benefit of playing in a game like this is all of us get an opportunity to see the great young talent that is in the NBA. So with my final pick, I'm going to go with Dyson Daniels from New Orleans. Love how he's been playing. Definitely can contribute to our team. And yeah, we're going to round out our team. Look, all I want for my players, I'm going to say the expectation is how I play. I want to go hard. I want to play hard. I want to have fun. And I want to win. Pretty easy.
And again, a defensive-minded guy. You see that steal in that Bulls game, taking it coast to coast, averaging almost a steal and a half per game. A guy, again, on that really deep New Orleans squad who has to fight for playing time in that very crowded backcourt. But he's the 8th pick of the 2022 draft. And not only did you fill a need for yourself, but now you put Jalen in an interesting spot where he thought he was being tricky with all these bigs, and now he's got an extra big here as well. I mean, this is like old school 1980s basketball with, what do you got, 3 or 4 7-footers on your team?
Correct, but look at the best offenses. Their best players don't dominate the ball, just like in Denver. The Joker doesn't dominate the ball. Let's go, Walker. Kessler the other night flirted with a double-double, been giving Utah quality minutes. Chet can be out facing while he can play in the paint. But the bottom line is we're going to protect that rim, and we're going to finish at the bucket as well.
No question. He's got some good international experience as well with Team USA. He's averaging more than 2.5 blocks per game. That is third in the NBA overall, not just among sophomores. So this is your squad. Let's look at him. congratulations to you guys. I mean, look at these rosters. It's obviously a great talent pool that we gave you guys of 21 players of the best rookies and sophomores.